I've been working with the Dallas Stars here for 7 years now, and I'm GM of their farm team in Austin, Texas, and I do a lot of NHL scouting, NCAA scouting for the team as well.
You've been doing this a while, like you said, and obviously a great organization to work for. Where, how much traveling are you doing a year? Any idea on the mileage that you put on?
I spend about 180 nights in a hotel a year, so that probably puts it in perspective pretty well. So 160 to 180 hockey games a year.
When you come to a tournament like this, what are you looking at?
I'm a little biased. I'm following Michigan Tech. Our coach is here. The players, I've watched a couple of them here for a while now, but this tournament's special to me. I've been around it for a long time. I've only missed it, I think, 2 years in the past 25. So I enjoy it, and it's a great environment. I wish, honestly, we were playing in the last game, but we're not. But that's the way it goes. And, yeah, I'm a little biased, I guess, but there's some good college hockey players, and I like watching it.
Is there something special about what these kind of tournaments bring out in players that allow you to maybe see their best hockey at a holiday tournament like this?
Well, it's interesting because it's a preparation leading up or the lack thereof. So I think it tells a lot about how the players prepare on their own coming in, because most don't have a lot of practices building up to this particular tournament or any Christmas tournament for that matter. So I think it means a lot to some players, and I think if guys come out and play well here, you know they've prepared, thought about it, and got themselves ready to showcase themselves here.
Any guys that you can let us know about that are in the NHL right now that you had a big hand in hand-picking or getting a good look at as far as recommendations?
Well, I've had a couple. I mean, a guy I coached way back when is Alex Burrows in Vancouver. I think everybody remembers Chris Connor. And there's a couple other guys, but the guys that... we've drafted a lot of good players in Dallas, and our guys out in the amateur field deserve a lot of credit.
Speaking about Chris Connor, injured obviously right now, but finally got a chance to play in front of the team that he grew up loving. You have to feel pretty good for him.
I do. I wish he was in a different sweater, to be quite honest. But other than that, no, Chris and I go back quite a ways. I've got nothing but the most respect for him, and I'm happy for him.
You think he has a shot at really making a presence here in Detroit? A very tough lineup to crack, much like Dallas is always a very big lineup.
Yeah, I think it's a tough nut to crack here because of the depth and just the way they operate their group. I think if he was in other organizations, he might have a better chance, but hey, he was here already. Unfortunately, got hurt, and who knows, he might still be playing if that wasn't the case.
Quite unusual for a player to be bouncing around to three teams that are so great as far as organizations, like Dallas, Pittsburgh, and Detroit.
Yeah, but you know what? He had elements. I think he cut his teeth with the Dallas Stars, of course. I think he figured out how to play in the NHL, and then he went to teams, Pittsburgh, play with pace. Detroit, they can play with pace and some skill. And, of course, they paid him good, too, so I think that all kind of ties in.
So you can't tell us who you're watching in particular here tonight?
Oh, there's a guy on Michigan Tech, two guys in particular I'm watching on Michigan Tech. One I'm pretty familiar with, second guy I'm getting to know a little bit better. And then there's some other guys, BC, and we have a drafted player on the University of Michigan, Alex Guptill, that I'll be watching tonight as well.
How many times do you have to see a guy before you have a really good feel for him on how he's going to be in the pros?
It varies. I mean, NHL and pro-wise, I see the NHL teams that I'm responsible for about 8 to 10 times, and then their minor league affiliate probably 6 times. College-wise, it's a little tougher. I don't have as much time, so I've got to make my decision fairly quick, but probably 2 or 3 times. And then you got to trust the work of your field scouts, and then also trust your network of people that you know.
We asked him if this tournament is special to him and, what he's feeling coming in here.
It was a great tournament for us. It's something that we always look forward to, as I think the guys on the team will attest to. It was one of our goals for this year, and I think we can, after a tough loss last night, we can still salvage a great weekend by coming in and playing another highly ranked team and having a good performance.
It looked like a game that we definitely could have won last night. We outshot Michigan State. What was your overall thought of the performance of the Huskies?
I thought the guys were ready to play. We didn't give up as much as we usually give up, which is a great sign for us moving forward. I thought that we attacked pretty well, and if our guys learn to go to the net and follow the pucks up and continue to pressure their goalie, then we'll start to score more goals, and we obviously could have won the game last night very easily. I don't think the best team did win last night, the team that played the best. I think we did come out and play well. We just we couldn't get to the goalie when we wanted to, and that's something that we have to focus on tonight and in future games.
Josh Robinson looked solid again last night. It, from our view, didn't look like either of the goals were his fault. He makes a save, and the rebound goes right to their guy in the back door in the power play goal, and obviously he was outmanned on that second goal. What was your thought on Josh's performance last night?
I thought Josh did a really good job of keeping us in the game late and giving us a chance to tie up the game when the game was on the line late. There wasn't a lot of action. Sometimes that's real tough for a goalie, but he made all the saves that he needed to make, and he made about four or five that could have easily gone in when we were pressing at the end of the game. So I was really pleased with the way he played, and as he's done all year long, he gave us a chance to win, and that's all you can expect from your goalie.
What about Palmisano last night? Did we challenge him enough, or was he as good as we made him look?
Well, he looked good. I mean, obviously he was ready to play, and he came out and he made the saves that he should make, and the only goal we got was a 5-on-3. I felt we could have shot the puck more at his feet and created some rebounds and then had guys going to the net. I think we got some shots from the outside where we basically laid the puck into him where he was able to either knock it away or get a hold of it, which basically takes your other forwards out of the play. So as much as he played well, I think that we could have created a lot more and had a lot more grade A chances to score if we would have place the puck a little better and gotten a little closer to him before we shot.
Prior to this 47th GLI, had you been back to this tournament since playing?
No, this was my first time back and suffered my first loss in the tournament last night, so it was not used to the 4 o'clock start, but it's great to be back here. The atmosphere is always great. We had I was really pleased with the support that we had yesterday, and hopefully we'll be able to send the Tech fans home happy tonight.
Well, we asked the coach after watching film what he thought, again, of the overall performance from last night's Michigan Tech-Michigan State game.
Well, when you review the tape and watch it, I thought we had a real good game. Strong in a lot of areas from the net out. Unfortunately, it came down to a couple bounces here or there, and they capitalized on two of their breaks, and then they put him in. We didn't get much puck luck around the net. You know, we had guys there, shots. He didn't see a couple. We're just really struggling scoring right now. We're, clutching our sticks a little tight. So we got to relax a little bit around the net, but also be a little bit more hungry around there, too. But overall, I was pleased with how we played.
Your former boss, Red, said about their game against Boston College that there is something to the Wolverines and Michigan State having a bit of more familiarity with this building. Do you buy into that at all now that you've seen both sides of it?
No, not at all. I mean, I thought we played a real good game. I can't tell you the team that played the best won last night. I mean, they took advantage of their chances. So, like I said, I thought, we did what we needed to do. We limited their scoring chances. We created quite a few of our own, and it just came down to a break here or there.
Really, it's a nice line combinations. You're not making much in the way of changes tonight. You must have liked what you saw there.
Well, a lot of good things. It's just the first game that we had those lines, so you don't want to blow everything up just because you lost a hockey game. If guys played poor or it wasn't any chemistry or whatnot, you might change it, but you don't want to change just for the sake of changing. I thought there were a lot of good things, and we want to see if those lines can grow into something more than what we even got last night.
Are we hoping for a little bit more grit around the net and determination to get that puck in past the goaltender tonight?
Well, yeah, not many goalies you're going to beat on that first shot with them getting clear view. So you have to create some traffic on the net, and then you have to find the loose pucks, and you have to get into that tough area, what we call it, to score goals. You got to get your hands a little dirty, and you got to get a little more gritty. So we're looking to do that tonight to hopefully create some good scoring chances.